That was wonderful.
Yay!
Please keep it going, guys, because we have another comedian for you. Please welcome the president of Second Floor Stand Up, Monica Delacroix.
You're so short.
I don't think it. I don't know. This is just weird. I was gonna take it out anyway. How have you been doing?
Yeah, good.
I'm in a really bad mood. I found out that the guy that I was talking to like played me. He decided to go back to his ex-girlfriend. So, like, now I kind of understand how, like, Qdoba feels when Chipotle decided to reopen after being on strike for 2 hours. Like, it doesn't matter how kind or caring or how much Qdoba takes care of its customers, because at the end of the day, Chipotle just has an easier name to pronounce. I think that Hallmark is like the saddest place in the world because it's just like a reminder of how badly human beings can mess up, essentially. There are just rows and rows of people being sorry, like sorry for skipping your birthday, sorry for passing out on your funeral, sorry. Sorry for deciding not to come to jury duty. Sorry for being. It's just like just rows and rows of people being sorry. And what I don't understand is like some of the things that people think is okay to just apologize with just cards. I mean, I remember seeing a card that was like, sorry for neglecting you. Nothing would make me feel more neglected than a piece of paper written by someone who I don't even know. They might not even live in this country, who I don't know, signed by the person giving it to me, and getting it in the mail so you don't even have to see me in person. So, not only does that piss me off, but on the cards, like, you can't even take out, like, the price tag of it. So all I have to do is flip it over to see how much you value me in the United States and in Canada. It wasn't very much, if you guys are. I don't like documentaries. I don't know if you guys like to watch a lot of documentaries. I don't like them. I think that documentaries are just an excuse to make low-budget reality TV shows. Like, I don't know, do you guys watch reality TV shows, right?
Yes.
Yeah. 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 In reality TV shows, you need like a house, you need like interesting people, you need a plan of some sort. You don't need a plan to make a documentary. Do you want to make a documentary on animals? Do it. Just go outside and film animals. That's a documentary. Did you watch March of the Penguins? It's just a camera on a bunch of penguins waddling around. March of the Penguins. Super Size Me. It's just a guy eating an obscene amount of food. He was gonna do it anyway. All he did was put a camera in his car. That's literally what he did. Catfish was just about a guy who was gonna go meet someone and he found out that they were lying about who they were on the internet. That happens to me all the time. You don't see me making a movie about it. And then what's even worse is like they never give you an actual ending to like the documentary. Like they'll try to give you like a little bit of closure. They'll give you like an update on what the characters are doing. But the update is no different than what they were doing for the past 2 hours of the movie. Jill still works at her dead end job. Mitch still hasn't found love. He's hoping, but he still hasn't. That's not an update. You have to be doing something differently than you were before. Like, I don't care if Jill found a new restaurant that she liked. Maybe she's volunteering on the weekends with the animal shelter. Maybe she started doing Tai Bo. I would take anything at this point. Documentaries just made me a pessimistic person because how can I expect my life to get any better if Jill's life can't get any better? And technically, she's a movie star. So, My cousin's gonna get married soon. Once she finds someone. So my favorite thing to do with her life is to like log on to her marriage, like to log on to her marriage profile and just like look at the other lonely people in the world, just for fun. If you guys don't know what a marriage profile is, it's essentially like, so you put a picture of your face, preferably your face. You write like a brief description on there, and then through some voodoo, the computer system will like hook you up with someone. And Rob like, Menica, that sounds a lot like a dating website. No, it's not. Because when you do a dating website, you expect it to fail. You literally go, you're at that point in your life where you're like, it's a dating website or I'm alone forever. And I'm sorry, it's probably gonna be both. But with a marriage website, you're investing your life. Actually, Indian people, when they get married, there's like a fire, and then they will walk around the fire, and for every circle they take around the fire, that's one lifetime that they're going to commit to the person. They do this 7 times. That 7 lifetimes. 1 time 7. That's 7. I would stop at half a circle and be like, you can go by yourself. I don't think they're just gonna throw 7 lifetimes in someone else's hands for no apparent reason. So, like, I've noticed a trend on these marriage websites where, like, moms will be writing their sons' biographies for them. Why? So one of the things that I saw was, like, this guy named Rajesh, and his mom wrote up, she's like, my son Rajesh would make such a good life partner, like, he's handsome, and he's smart, and he hasn't never forgotten his mom's birthday. I was like, why are you lying? Handsome? There's a picture on there, first of all. I can see it. What's going on. Smart, he can't even write a paragraph for himself. And I'm just going to assume that the birthday thing's a lie, but I just don't understand how you can go a whole lifetime without having to write a descriptive paragraph about yourself and expect that you're ready to get married. Who wrote his cover letter for him? Who's going to write his vows for him? Those are not even descriptions, those are promises. Not for 1 lifetime, for 7 lifetimes. What is he gonna do when his mom dies? Who is gonna write the eulogy? I feel like she probably already has one. Here lies Rajesh's mom. She was a mother, a friend, an avid member of marriage websites. Ladies, he's still single. Honestly, all his mom does is write something and have someone else take the credit for it. So I think she would be a good employee of Hallmark. That's my time. Follow me on Twitter. That's it.